Hi guys, so I've just walked up the road to another place called Dar El Bahar, and it's very, very different. I'm on the ground floor of this one. It's a lot smaller, I'll show you around in a moment, but for me, I'm happier. It's off the main road and it's quiet. The beds have not got a single stain on them. The pillows smell lovely and fresh. There's even soap in the bathroom. So at the last place, they didn't even give me soap. And not a single thing appears to be broken. So the toilet seat appears to be fine. I'm gonna have a little look around because I can hear the sea from here. So I think we're quite close to it. I'm gonna go up to the roof terrace and take a look out. And then I'm gonna go and get some lunch. So, you know, it's a lot smaller than the last room. When I walked into the last room, it was really impressive because it was a big, spacious room, you know, very airy, very light, but it just wasn't fit for purpose. They have said that they will not give me any refund at all. So I booked in for 5 nights and I stayed for one. That's fine. It said, you know, that they don't give refunds and that's discretionary. They offered another room, but by this point they've already shown their hand. The pillows are not clean. The toilet seat's broken. I mean, they're kind of like fundamental things that you need to kind of get on. You know, I went up for breakfast in the morning, and there were a whole load of seats to sit on and only one seat was dry. All of the others were soaking wet. So it's a good thing that I was the only person at breakfast. So, you know, they need the money more than I do by the look of it. They need to invest it in their hotel. Anyway, so I'm happy. I've got a smaller room, but it's quieter, it's a lot cleaner, and it's still really in the centre of the Medina. So I'm done talking about it now. Let's just forget about that place and enjoy the rest of the holiday. The view from the new accommodation. Look at this. Oh, that's amazing. Oh, look at all the seagulls. They're all just sitting on the beach. Okay, so coming here, just next door is a really posh hotel, and you can see over onto their terrace. Again, there's just sea in every direction. Oh, so that's where we were the other day with all of the cannons. Okay, so the sea view has made me a lot happier, and now let's go and get something to eat. Just to compare, I was coming down the stairs and this room was open, and it's one of the double rooms. So this is what you get in a double room. It's very pretty, spacious and light, but no sea view on this side. I went out and grabbed falafel from a street vendor. It was delicious. On the way back, I also picked up a prickly pear, which are very popular in Essaouira.
This is the fruit of the cacti that are dying off due to cochineal. I've only ever had it once before and was not a fan. They look nice, but they're just a big ball of hard seeds, difficult to chew and easy to hurt your teeth. Still, I had a go just in case I'd misremembered what they tasted like. I hadn't. They're awful. They also cover you in these tiny little spikes, like itching powder. They're hard to avoid and even harder to get rid of.
I just found this wandering around in my covers. I'm not sure what it is. It seems like a giant weevil. I don't think it was trying to eat me. I'm going to put it out the window and let it get on with its night. I'm sure it's going to be happier out there. Off you go. Have a good time.